Have you ever bought paintings while traveling and need to frame and restretch them, but haven't got to it because you couldn't do it yourself? Well, keep on watching. After this video, you'll have that painting up in no time. I love to travel, and if you're watching this video, I'm sure you do too. I bought these beautiful paintings from this amazing artist in DR, and I kept them rolled up because I felt like it would be this big production to get them done. But once I started, I was so regretful that I didn't start sooner. So let's get to it. Okay, so I bought 4 3/4 by 3/4 by 36 inch wood dowels from Home Depot and cut 2 at 24 inches and 2 at 28 and a half inches. I used a reciprocating saw, but for a straighter edge, I would recommend using a circular saw, but if you don't have power tools, you can use a hand saw. When gluing your frame, you can use Gorilla Glue or a glue gun, whatever you have available. Make sure you put two staples on each corner for double support. You also can use a 90 degrees corners clamp when gluing your frame for a more perfect square. I wanted a 24 inch wide by 30 inch tall frame. I left this clip to show you. If you don't take into account that 3/4 piece on the top and bottom, your frame will come up longer. It will add an inch and a half more to your total height. So make sure you subtract an inch and a half from your vertical pieces. My frame ended up being 31 inches instead of 30 inches tall. So don't make that mistake and keep that in mind before cutting your pieces. As you can see, I rolled out this amazing painting and flipped both the painting and the frame over. And because this painting was already on a frame previously, I used the frame marks that was on the painting to realign the painting to fit my new frame. And while you do that, you can also put staples just to hold down your painting in place before you actually start to put your final staples on your frame. When you get to the corners of this project, all you have to do is slide one part of the painting underneath the one on the top and just make sure it's straight and the corners are put together neatly. And just staple it and do this all the way around and to all of the four corners until your project is all done. So keep on stretching that painting because when you're done, you're gonna be so excited the way it is going to come out. So I hope you enjoyed this video so far. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel because there will be more videos like this. And make sure you comment below and tell me what you think so far. Do not leave because up next, I will show you how to hang your painting with clear wire string. So keep on watching. All right, so in order to hang your painting's unique hooks, I use these hooks and I place them on the top of the painting so that I can connect my clear wire string to it. And also up next, I'll show you how to make it the exact size you need it. All right, you guys, so everything that I use is in the description below. So if you didn't write down everything so far, don't worry about it. You can go down to the description and get all of the information that you need. So when using this clear wire, you have to make a loop on both sides so that you'll be able to hang your painting. So as you can see, I'm measuring my clear wire to the distance that I want it. I actually made it a little longer so that I can create that loop. I put it in the crimp sleeve and use a needle nose pliers, or you can use a regular pliers. Whatever you have on hand, you can use. I created two of these and was able to get it the length that I wanted it. And when I wanted to mount it, I measured from the wall because I had my painting in front of my window. So I measured from the wall to where my hook is on my painting and made a mark, and then did that on the other side of my painting where the hook was, marked it, and then screw two hooks on the ceiling, and then hung up my beautiful painting. I hope this video gave you the tools to get those paintings on the wall. If you enjoy videos like this, check these videos out. And also make sure you subscribe so that you can see more home decor, DIY, arts and crafts, and more videos. So like this video, share it, and comment below and tell me what you think. See you soon.